Michael Whittaker's been studying sea urchins since he was a student. But it's not the urchins themselves he's interested in, as much as their sperm and eggs. He believes there's a possibility that chemistry plays a role in the first task that faces the sperm.
There'll be a short distance that the sperm has to swim to find the egg, of the order of a few millimetres. But nonetheless, it has to swim in the right direction. If it swims off into infinity, then it's never going to achieve its end, which is to fertilise an egg. And to do that, the sperm then needs to be able to sense that the egg is there. Probably there's a chemoattractant that the egg releases, and the sperm then senses that chemoattractant, swims up the gradient, and finds its goal, which is the egg at the end of the road.
In many ways, sea urchin eggs and sperm are similar to those of humans. Within the head of all sperm are special chemicals. When contact is made, there's a chemical reaction. This chemical reaction is the key to getting the sperm into the egg. The reaction makes the outer walls of the head of the sperm rupture, and powerful enzymes break out. These enzymes eat into the cell wall, allowing the sperm to enter. Chemistry also has a crucial role in explaining what happens next, the tickle.
So having found the egg, another task that confronts the sperm is then to activate this egg. And it's a little bit more difficult than one might think, at least naively, because the egg is enormous. It's 100 microns in diameter. The sperm is very small, probably about 1/1000th of that size. And so the question is, how can the sperm do that? How can this tiny sperm activate this enormous egg? Or another way of thinking about it is, how does the egg know that the sperm is there, it being so large and the sperm being so small? So in fact, it's the egg itself which has a mechanism for self-activation, auto-activation. There's a calcium wave that the egg has already programmed into it. And what it's looking for, the egg is very sensitive, and the egg is just looking for the tickle from the sperm that tells it that the sperm is there, and it then explodes. And that explosion is fertilization, this explosion of calcium.
For several years, researchers have believed that metal ions play a crucial role in communication. Whittaker and his colleagues have been developing techniques to understand the role of calcium. The egg is injected with chemical dyes, which when in contact with calcium are known to fluoresce. Using this method, researchers explore the role calcium ions play in the egg's first few minutes of life. The sperm tickles the egg with dramatic results. It propagates a massive release of calcium ions across the cell. This major change in the concentration of just one element produces crucial changes in the egg.
It does a number of things, and one of the things that it does is to raise an envelope around the egg. It's called a fertilization envelope, and that's a protective envelope that stops other sperm getting at the egg once it's fertilized, and also protects the egg from knocks and bangs while it's developing. In the end, the embryo will hatch out of that envelope later in development.
This wave of calcium is also the starting gun for life. The wave is the chemical signal for the egg to trigger the process of creating a life. Indeed, the calcium wave is just as important as the sperm. Perhaps it's even more important.
There are some insects, for example, that can develop parthenogenetically, so-called. In other words, there is no sperm, there's just an egg that develops spontaneously within the insect, and it's a way of compressing generations. You can make this happen artificially, in fact, with sea urchins. If you treat the sea urchins with a calcium ionophore, which is something that will make that calcium go up, cause that calcium explosion without there being a sperm around, then indeed the egg will go on to develop and you'll get little sea urchins that don't have a father.